Good afternoon, and welcome to the celebration of the Mass for the first Sunday of Advent. At this time, we kindly ask that you please turn off all cell phones and electronic devices. As a Eucharistic-centered community, all of our actions flow out of our love for the sacrament, out of reverence for the Eucharist, and out of respect for each other. We kindly ask that you remain in the pew until the Mass is completed and the celebrant has processed out of the church. The scripture readings for today's Mass can be found at page 31 in your hymnal. The order of the Mass with the congregation's responses can be found on your pew card or on page 3 of the hymnal. Our opening hymn is number 41 in your hymnal, Come Thou Long Expected Jesus, number 41. Our priest celebrant today is Father Rocky. Would you please stand and join in singing our opening hymn?
Good afternoon, everyone. Let us pray together in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. We begin this season of Advent by calling on the Lord to bless this wreath. Its evergreen branches are formed into an unending circle as a sign of the Lord's eternal love. Its candles symbolize the light of Christ, growing ever brighter in our hearts. Let us now take a moment to pray to the Lord for his blessing upon this wreath and on each one of us as we joyfully await the coming of our Savior. God, our Father, you redeem us by sending your Son as a light in the darkness. He came as a sign of your love for us and as the promise of sharing in eternal life. We now ask you to bless this wreath and its candles and let it remind us of the light of Christ shining among us and leading us to share in your kingdom. May this Advent season deepen our faith in his birth and our longing for his return in glory, for he lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. Let us pray. Grant your faithful, we pray, Almighty God, the resolve to run forth to meet your Christ with the righteous deeds at his coming, so that, gathered at his right hand, they may be worthy to possess the heavenly kingdom. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. The days are coming, says the Lord, when I will fulfill the promise I made to the house of Israel and Judah. In those days, in that time, I will raise up for David a just shoot. He shall do what is right and just in the land. In those days, Judah shall be safe, and Jerusalem shall dwell insecure. This is what they call her, the Lord our justice, the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Our responsorial psalm is, "To you, O Lord, I lift my soul."
Soul. and commands. The Lord's secret is for those who fear him. To them he reveals his covenant. To you, O Lord, I lift my soul.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. Brothers and sisters, may the Lord make you increase and abound in love for one another and for all, just as we have for you, so as to strengthen your hearts to be blameless in holiness before our God and Father at the coming of our Lord Jesus with all his holy ones. Amen. Finally, brothers and sisters, we earnestly ask and exhort you in the Lord Jesus that, as you received from us how you should conduct yourselves to please God, and as you are conducting yourselves, you do so even more. For you know what instructions we gave you through the Lord Jesus. The word of the Lord.
Be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Jesus said to his disciples, "There will be signs in the sun, the moon, and the stars, and on earth nations will be in dismay, perplexed at the roaring of the sea and the waves. People will die of fright in anticipation of what is coming upon the world, for the powers of the heavens will be shaken. And then they will see the Son of Man coming in a cloud with power and great glory. But when these signs begin to happen, stand erect and raise your heads, because your redemption is at hand. Beware that your hearts do not become drowsy or carousing and drunkenness and the anxieties of daily life, and that they catch you by surprise like a trap. For that day will assault everyone who lives on the face of the earth. Be vigilant at all times and pray that you have the strength to escape the tribulations that are imminent and to stand before the Son of Man." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you. We heard in the first reading, "I will raise up for David a just shoot. He shall do what is right and just in the land." That first reading, the prophet gives an image of new life springing forth. And that new life will bring forward to the people God's eternal fidelity to us. The new one that will be coming will complete the old ways. Those who yearn for times of prosperity and integrity, those who are in darkness, those who are in cold, are promised a future that will be safer, more righteous, even more so than the old times that we long for now. And that someone who will be coming will bring recovery and stability to the land. And he will be therefore worth waiting for. And in this fast-paced world that we live in, where we have learned to have instant gratification, instant rewards, instant results, we are being taught to slow down, to learn to wait patiently, especially for that someone who is really important to wait for. And that's what this Advent season is really all about. 4 weeks of waiting. We study ways that we could be waiting for that someone who is coming. And we have the liturgical season's decoration for Advent to remind us that we are still waiting. The Advent wreath that you saw lit just a few minutes ago, the candles that are bluish, purplish, first of all, they remind us that we are now waiting. We are now at the time between the first coming of Christ on that manger in Bethlehem as a baby, as a son of Mary and Joseph. And we are at the time waiting for Jesus' second coming as the King of all creation and the Judge of all. When Jesus comes again, it will be the end of the world, of all creation as we know it. And so Jesus says in the gospel reading, there will be signs in the sun, the moon, the stars, and on the earth. Nations will be in dismay, perplexed by the roaring of the seas and the waves. And so with all the things that we're seeing happening in the world now, it makes many of us think, could the end be happening in the year 2022? Many of you have asked the clergy about that, with the pandemic, the fires, the forest fires, people killing one another, disease arising. You've asked, is this the end of the world? But instead of taking that passage literally to see what may be going on in the world, perhaps we should instead take a look at ourselves, what's going on within us personally, so that we can take a look within our heart and how we can prepare for the coming of Jesus Christ. To do that, we need to check on the disorders within ourselves. Because we have to be able to answer the question, when Jesus arrives, what would he see in you? In me. Today, God is calling us to begin our preparation personally, for Jesus is on his way towards us from heaven for the second time. We heard, "Beware that your hearts do not become drowsy from carousing and drunkenness and the anxieties of daily life, and that they catch you by surprise like a trap." The one thing that Jesus wants to end is our indifferences, our being passive, not caring for one another. St. Paul reminds us, increase and abound in love for one another and for all. Jesus, who lived in this world 2,000 years ago, calls us now to repent from sin and to live out the signs of love, to accept, to be patient, to take care of, to be compassionate, to be forgiving towards anyone he may bring towards us every moment of our life. We are to turn the sadness caused by sin into joy by being the best persons we could be. And therefore, Advent is also a time for the sacrament of reconciliation, when we can kneel in front of Jesus and beg him through the priest to heal us of our sinfulness, of our disordered desires. Jesus is the one we are waiting for, to restore the human race and all of his creation towards peace and justice. He is the one who will reestablish order and help us to gain the identity that we have lost. And this gives us hope. This gives us a goal to hold on to, so we could continue towards the future. The Advent wreath we're looking at is a circle made of leaves of the evergreen. Never loses the leaves, even in the winter cold. It's a symbol of eternity. Jesus is the future peace and justice, who will always be there for us and not abandon us. We are the ones who are abandoning him. And Jesus keeps calling us to himself. He wants us to actively seek him and pursue him towards the kingdom of God, and not just for ourselves, but for every person that we meet. Because when we are close to Jesus, then he will give us the gift of having the perfect love that we are looking for and can't seem to find in this world. And he will allow us to live forever, more than the 100 years that we are looking at here on earth. That's what eternal life is, being in the presence of God forever and never seeing any more sin. The four candles on the wreath represent the 4 weeks of Advent, until we celebrate the birthday of Jesus on Christmas Eve. Each Sunday, we will light a candle until Christmas Eve, when all four of the candles will be lit. Why candles? The candles represent the light of Christ. When we do bad things, we want to hide in the darkness so that nobody else can see the bad things we've done. But when we do good, we don't need to hide. We stay in the light. There's nothing to be ashamed of. And so the candlelights stand for Jesus, the light of the world. He reminds us how to be good and not to be bad. The one pink rose candle will be the third candle, the third week of Advent. Pink as a symbol of joy, hope, that we have one more week until we celebrate the birth of Christ. And so this Advent season is really a time for us to prepare spiritually in the midst of all the hustle and bustle of shopping, preparing parties for our family members and friends. What are we preparing for in Advent? We are preparing ourselves to accept the gift of Jesus Christ, who came during that first Christmas day and promises to come back again in the future to pick us up and to take us home with him in the land of eternal life, where all the peace, the rest, the love, the unity, everything good we long for, he wants to give to us. And while we are waiting for him to arrive, Jesus gives us what to do. He said, be vigilant at all times and pray. Rather than despairing about the end, we pray for a new beginning in our own personal lives, starting now. Please stand, and together let us profess our faith. I believe one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, to the resurrection of the dead, the life of the world to come. As we enter this holy season of Advent, we prepare our hearts to receive the Messiah. With joyful hope, let us offer our prayers to the Lord, and our response will be, Lord, hear our prayer.
For an increase in religious vocations, may the Lord bless those discerning priesthood or consecrated life with generous and open hearts. Let us pray to the Lord. for a world that will raise up a people who protect the vulnerable, especially the aged and the unborn. Let us pray to the Lord. For those who struggle with questions about their faith, may the power of God's grace bring them peace and understanding. Let us pray to the Lord. For this faith community, may the Holy Spirit help us increase and abound in love for one another as children of our Heavenly Father. Let us pray to the Lord. For those who have died, especially Harry Royston, may they live in glory forever with God and all the saints. Let us pray to the Lord. For our personal needs that we now place before the Lord in the silence of our hearts. Let us pray to the Lord.
And together let us ask the angels to help us to have a deeper faith and a deeper love for Christ. Saint Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Loving Father, please hear and answer our prayers this day in your wisdom. We ask all these through Jesus, who is our Lord forever and ever. Amen. Amen.
Our hymn for the preparation of the gifts can be found at number 762 in your hymnal, To You, O Lord, number 762.
My soul, my God.
Please stand and pray as brothers and sisters that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Accept, we pray, O Lord, these offerings we make, gathered from among your gifts to us. And may what you grant us to celebrate devoutly here below gain for us the prize of eternal redemption. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Lift up the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he assumed at his first coming the lowliness of the human flesh, and so fulfilled the design you formed long ago, and opened for us the way to eternal salvation, that when he comes again in glory and in majesty, and all is at last made manifest, we who watch for that day may inherit the great promise in which now we dare to hope. And so with the angels and the archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and from the world's beginning you are ceaselessly at work so that the human race may become holy just as you yourself are holy. Look, we pray, upon your people's offerings and pour out upon them the power of your Spirit, that they may become the body and blood of your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, in whom we too are your sons and daughters. Indeed, though we once were lost and could not approach you, you loved us with the greatest love. For your Son, who alone is just, handed himself over to death and did not disdain to be nailed for our sake to the wood of the cross. But before his arms were outstretched between heaven and earth to become the lasting sign of your covenant, he desired to celebrate the Passover with his disciples. As he ate with them, he took bread. And giving you thanks, he said the blessing. He broke the bread and gave it to them, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, knowing that he was about to reconcile all things in himself through his blood to be shed on the cross, he took the chalice filled with the fruit of the vine. And once more giving you thanks, he handed the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of your Son, Jesus Christ, who is our Passover and our surest peace, we celebrate his death and resurrection from the dead. And looking forward to his blessed coming, we offer you, who are our faithful and merciful God, this sacrificial victim who reconciles to you the human race. Look kindly, most compassionate Father, on those you unite to yourself by the sacrifice of your Son, and grant that by the power of the Holy Spirit, as they partake of this one bread and one chalice, they may be gathered into one body in Christ, who heals every division. Be pleased to keep us always in communion of mind and heart, together with Francis, our Pope, and William, our Bishop. Help us to work together for the coming of your kingdom, until the hour when we stand before you, saints among the saints, in the halls of heaven, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her blessed spouse, the blessed apostles, and all the saints, and with all our deceased brothers and sisters, whom we humbly commend to your mercy. Then freed at last from the wound of corruption, and made fully into a new creation, we shall sing to you with gladness the thanksgiving of Christ, who lives for all eternity. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. And now we give ourselves to God. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, deliver us. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give to you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Take away the sins of the world. Amen.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Establish your house on the highest mountain. peace of God's kingdom. Maranatha, Maranatha, come, O Lord, and set us free. You call us to beat our swords into plowshares and our spears into pruning hooks. Maranatha, Maranatha, come, O Lord, and set us free. You call the house of Jacob to walk in your light.
We pray an act of spiritual communion for those who are at home. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. We have a few announcements. Our poor boxes this weekend are designated for Anna's House of Bel Air to provide services to homeless women and children. Your generosity is very much appreciated. Our Christmas gift card project continues. There will be a special box, poor box, in the narthex until December 5th to accept gift cards from local merchants so that our own struggling families in the parish will have a nice Christmas. We thank you for your support. Please join us Tuesday evening from 5 p.m. to 7 p.m. in the historic church for adoration of the Blessed Sacrament, praying for the protection of life in our culture. Next Saturday is our annual Christmas Bazaar. We hope you can stop by. This is also the last week to turn in your raffle tickets. They need to be turned in by this coming Thursday. If you need any more, there are some in the narthex, and they'll be for sale the day of the bazaar. And then next weekend, the scouts will be outside by the grotto collecting new and unwrapped toys for Toys for Tots. As always, we appreciate your generosity. Please stand and let us pray. May these mysteries, O Lord, in which we have participated, profit us, we pray, for even now, as we walk amid passing things, you teach us by them to love the things of heaven and hold fast to what endures. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. And may the Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace. Thanks be to God.
Our closing hymn is number 58, The Advent of Our King, number 58.